The long-awaited Flash movie hits theater this June and is one of the year's most anticipated films. The first poster they released is this one, which I think is extremely nice and well done. As you can see, the entire poster has blue as the dominant color, and the only different thing from the scene is Flash, which has his red suit. The overall concept is just amazing, but there is still one problem. They released another poster, which I really don't like. In this video, I will remake this poster and fix some of the issues that I see here, of course keeping the exact concept and style. Before doing that, let me tell you what I think is wrong. First, let's talk about the colors. I like the way the sky has shades of blue and orange, but there is something about it that feels rather pale to me. While the combination of blue and orange creates a nice contrast, the overall intensity seems a bit low. Another thing that bothers me is the crazy amount of smoke. Personally, I feel like you can't see all the cool stuff around, like the rubble where Batman is sitting. It's like the smoke is stealing away all the little details that could make this scene so much better. You can probably see that there are no highlights whatsoever on the rocks around Flash. He has a big amount of light around him and none of it reflects on the ground and surrounding areas. So there are no highlights. And one final thing is the big amount of blur on the foreground rock. Keep in mind that I couldn't get the high resolution assets they have. For example, I had to cut out all the characters from the original poster because I didn't find any online, and for the Batwing I found a very low resolution image that kinda has the same perspective. Now that you know all of this, let's go to Photoshop. As I said earlier, I will keep the exact concept from the original poster, but I will make the entire composition from scratch, starting with the sky, which is also the background of the image. I made the entire background blue, and then with an orange solid color adjustment layer, I painted the left side of the sky with a soft brush, resulting in a dual color theme. For the ground, I used a few rubble images found online. I think they're pretty similar to what they used, so it was good enough. After the selection, I adjusted the light and colors with levers and color balance adjustment layers. As you can see, I had to make sure that the characters maintain the same position as the original image. This required me to make adjustments to the environment in order to align them correctly. Masking was a crucial step in making everything look natural, and Batman looks like he is actually standing on the rubble. After that, I simply focused on coloring and adding more assets to the composition. Once again, I used the rubble image for the background and I placed it on the right side, and on top of that will be standing Supergirl. The selection process wasn't that precise considering the fact that it is a destroyed building. I merged the two images together and I adjusted the levels as I did before, integrating them into the scene. Using a color balance adjustment layer was the final step to ensure a look that matched the entire vibe of the poster. I quickly moved to adding shadows, which if you don't know, shadows and highlights are one of the most important aspects in photo manipulation. I already have a video in which I talk about beginner mistakes in Photoshop, and it includes this one, so make sure to check it out if you are interested. Back to this edit, I manually added an exposure adjustment layer to every image, inverted the mask, and with a soft brush I started to paint all over the place. I had to keep in mind one thing, that being the light source which comes from the left side. Now comes the part that I like the most, adding visual effects. I used a few lightning overlays for Flash with different forms and shapes, and along with warp and masking I also had to make sure that they are the same color as the character has them in the movies, which is an orange yellowish tint. Because they are very bright, it also means that the surrounding area must have highlights. After using the hue and saturation adjustment layer for every single overlay and finding the right values, I had to make a glowing effect with a solid color set on linear dodge add. Now that I have a good light source, I started to paint highlights on the rubbles placed on the foreground. Now it all comes down to adding a few details to the composition, working a bit with shadows and trying to make them more accurate and tweaking different values. As I already mentioned, because the light comes from the left side, it means that the right side of the Supergirl must have some shadows. For the particles Flash has, I used an image from the bundle I got from FaceRunner and it was perfect in this case. Also, the environment needed some dust around and for that another particle overlay came in handy. Once again, some minor adjustments here and there, including highlights. The original poster has some fire embers on the foreground close to the camera, so I also had to include them. Well, this is the part that I don't like. I've searched for almost 2 hours only to find a high resolution image for the Batwing, but unfortunately I ended up using one that is really, really bad in terms of clarity. But I guess I have to work with what I found. Editing this was also extremely hard, being far away in the distance didn't help that much, even if I tried to hide all the imperfections with some layers. For any object that is far away from the camera where the shot is taken, you need to remember that it needs a small amount of blur and to match the color of the background. In this case, the colors used are orange and yellow. And this is the final result after applying a camera raw filter. I got a few messages from you on Instagram in which you asked me about making a video for this movie poster. I will let you decide which one you like most. Personally, I feel that mine is just more eye-catching in terms of colors. I also reduced the amount of smoke and now you can see more details. The only thing that really upsets me is the Batwing. Personally, I think it turned out extremely bad. I tried removing it completely, but that would ruin this edit because it won't be the same concept anymore. The sky looks way different, now we can clearly see both colors, and for me the particles used really stand out, they add that magic effect to the entire composition. Taking into consideration that online you can't find the exact assets they used when creating this and the fact that this poster was made in almost 3 hours with a limited amount of stock assets, I think this turned out pretty good for a movie poster. This is the reason why it is important to work with high resolution assets, because no matter how much you try, how many effects you apply, it won't make the final composition look any better. And also, if you're a beginner in photo manipulation and want to know more about how to make compositions, I have this video dedicated to this topic in which I'll tell you more. Other than that, thank you guys so much for watching and I will see you in my next video.